Hi there, welcome to this video. Let's see together how to manage and edit your media imported in your project with CyberLink PowerDirector 14, easily and shortly. If you have problems with the accent in this video, enable our closed captions clicking on the CC icon in the bottom right corner. In the beginner tutorial, we have seen the very basic steps to create and edit your project in full with all its basic components or clips. There are four main important clips inside your timeline: title clips, audio clips, video clips, and image clips. The way you edit them may be slightly different between one kind of clip and another. Title clips can be fully edited and personalized with effects and motion through a dialog box called the Title Designer. If you want to know how to manage 2D and 3D text in full, check out our related video in this guide. Let's see how to edit audio clips. If you double-click on the audio clip interested, the Trim Audio dialog box appears. This is used to edit the sound waveform in order to trim and cut all parts you don't need, more precisely than what you can do using the general timeline. You can zoom in and out, clicking and dragging from the timeline above. Then use the Mark In and the Mark Out buttons to place two markers on the timeline, used to trim the sound waveform. These markers will be placed on the exact position of the playhead on the waveform. More below, select Original to hear the whole waveform as it is originally, or choose Output to check the results of your modifications inside the Trim Audio window. These changes will be definitely applied when you click on OK below. To edit the audio waveform itself, you need to select the audio clip and go to Edit Audio right above. To go on, you do need Audio Director or Wave Editor softwares for this. Let's see how to edit and manage image and video clips. You can trim video clips simply clicking and dragging their edges on the left or right, directly on your timeline. If you need to be more precise, select the clip and go to the scissor icon above to open the trim window. Above, you can select between single trim and multi-trim. Single trim works just like the trim audio window seen before, trimming the video clip using the two Mark In and Mark Out buttons. Multi-trim is more advanced, since it is able to trim your video clip in multiple parts, using the Mark In and the Mark Out buttons. Each part identified by a couple of markers is called segment, and each of them is listed on the right. Go to OK to apply the changes. This window is not available for image clips, since these are a unique static picture. If you double-click on an image or a video clip, you will open the PiP Designer, a window that collects all tools used to apply a very good picture-in-picture effect, also called PiP. A PiP effect consists in placing an image or a video on another picture or video while you play. To show properly all tools inside the PiP Designer, let's apply a PiP effect with an image and a video clip, for example. If you want to apply an image on a video, make sure to place the image clip on a lower track, in order to overlap the video clip. Then open the PiP Designer, double-clicking on the image clip. This has an embedded preview that shows how your clip is behaving inside your overall project. Hold Ctrl down and use your mouse wheel if you need to zoom in or out. On the left, under Properties tab, you have all the tools to set a good PIP effect. Position is used to adjust precisely the position of the clip on the preview. To move fast, instead, just click and drag the clip directly from the preview. Use Scale to size the clip precisely, or use the white nodes on the preview. Uncheck Maintain Aspect Ratio to deform the clip if you need. Adjust Transparency and Rotation through the Opacity and the Rotation sections. Chroma key is used to make colors transparent. Select the color through the color picker on the left and click on the clip to pick a color. This will be treated according to the options chosen on the left. Remember to check and uncheck an effect to enable or disable it. The following effects are effective for PIP effects. Use shadow to apply shadow under such clip, setting distance, blur and opacity. Use reflection to apply reflection. Use border to apply outer glows. Use flip to flip the clip vertically or horizontally. Use 3D settings to adjust depth in case of 3D projects, and use fades to apply fade-in and fade-out transitions to make the clip appear or disappear in time. Under the Motion tab, you can choose and apply a motion path on the clip. This changes the position of the clip in time, following the green arrow that appears on the preview. This arrow can be edited just like a clip. Use the white nodes to scale the path. Click and drag to move it with the clip as well. Use the green nodes to rotate the path. Plus, you can drag the yellow nodes or the green path itself to edit the motion path. If you want to remove any motion path, just click on the blue cross on the left. Under Rotation settings, you can apply a continuous rotation on the clip, choosing between a clockwise or a counterclockwise rotation. If you apply a rotation over 360 degrees, multiple consecutive rotations will be applied. Fade-in, fade-out transitions, motion paths and rotations do add keyframes on your local timeline. If you want to know more about keyframes and effects that change in time, check out our related video in this guide. All those effects are applied throughout all the clip's duration, so the shorter is the clip, the faster the effects will be. You can also apply motion blur on the clip. This is quite useful to make a more realistic effect in case you make the clip move. Often check how your clip is using the player on the preview. Remember to stop the preview before going on editing the clip. If you don't stop the player first, you won't be able to apply or edit any effect. There is also the Mask tab. This is used to apply a masking effect on the clip, choosing the shape on the left. The white side represents the parts of the clip visible, while the checked ones, all parts that will stay hidden. You can click and drag to move the mask in order to show other parts of the clip, or drag the white nodes to scale it. You can also invert the mask and adjust the feather contour. If you want to adjust the mask object precisely, go to Object Settings. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our full guide to learn more about CyberLink PowerDirector 14.